Because you're doing a great job. Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Good morning, everybody. Good evening, everybody. Depends on where you are in the world. This is a one-subject Periscope. Camera out. Hey, everybody. Hey, how are you? We're just going to do one subject. It just reminded me. I had an awesome, question that somebody asked this morning on, they made a comment, actually, on one of my postings on Facebook. And it was with a dog. It was with a dog that was learning the place command, and this dog is out of control. Hold on one second. Hey, Ange. Hey, buddy. Can you just maybe go play in another room or outside, or just keep it quiet just for a little bit while I finish this up? Yeah, I know, honey. Okay. So Angelo is playing. All right. And yeah, Ange is everywhere. So there's a video that was with a dog named, I believe, Alex, and the dog, it's the white dog that has a scar across his chest from, it's at the training center, and it's a dog that ran into the dishwasher and cut its chest open, and it's an out-of-control dog, jumps on counters, jumps on tables, doesn't listen to anything at all the owners have to say, and the, one of the questions which someone was asked, which was a great question, was, I've got a dog just like that. How much exercise are you going to be giving that dog? And I want to clarify, I really want to talk to people about exercise does not get good behavior. So just keep that in mind. So exercise does not get good behavior. All you're doing is building an athlete. Now, we're very pro-exercise. We believe very, very strongly in exercise. We do exercise our dogs, but we don't exhaust them physically in order to get good behavior. We don't. Or mentally, as far as like all kinds of games. What we do is we train dogs how to be calm. Now, yes, we have exercise, yes, we have structure, yes, we do obedience, yes, we do good manners, but we also spend a lot of time on calmness. When you train a dog on how to be calm, the default command then is, I'll just lie down and hang out. So a lot of times people are struggling with their dog's good behavior, and they're constantly being told that their dog has to be more exercise. Now, if you're only walking your dog for 5 minutes or 10 minutes a day, of course you need to get your dog more exercise. If your dog is kenneled up for 10 hours a day, you come home, you let it out the back door, bring it back in, of course you're gonna have probably some issues. But you don't have to exercise your dog for 3, 4, 5 hours a day. I've heard of people saying that you gotta just, you know, run your dog on a bike for 2 hours. Now, that would be nice. That would be great. Number one, a lot of people don't have time for that. If you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I don't believe in conditioned relaxation either. You know, conditioned relaxation, I'm not going to discount it. Some of my colleagues do it. I just call it the place command or the down command. You don't need fancy terms like conditioned relaxation. Again, no disrespect to the people that are doing it all. Some of my colleagues do it. But to me, how about this? Shut up and go lie down, right? Simple concept. So that's my training. It's just like, you know, that's my training. So, hey, Haruka, how are you? So what you can do is go to my website and you can go to my videos. So I want to talk to everybody about the place command. The place command is having a dog go to a object, such as a dog bed, a raised platform, a carpet square, a bath mat, a t-shirt, go to it and go lie down. What that teaches the dog to do is, number one, be more relaxed naturally, but obviously absolutely be more relaxed on command. A good example is girl travels with me all the time. So obviously I can't exercise her a ton, or some days I don't exercise her at all. But she knows that when she's told to go, I don't know, go to place or go lie down, she assumes she's gonna be there for a while. So, and those, by the way, are not my dogs barking, those are dogs across the canal, just for clarification. What place is, every single person should do place. Now, sometimes I see comments where people will be, they'll see a picture of place and they'll say, oh, that's something I need to do for my dog. That's another thing that lets me know that I don't know if people are quite understanding the concept of training. Of course you should be doing that with your dog. All dogs should know obedience. All dogs should know default calming obedience, which is place or down. Place or down. Every single dog out there should learn how to go to a crate and shut up, go lie down and shut up, and go to a mat and shut up. And it really is, those, each one of those is like a 10-minute training protocol. It's not that hard to do. If you go to my YouTube channel, I probably have about 15 how-to videos just on place. It also helps great New Jersey dogs, right? It also helps the dog be calmer. It helps the dog be calmer. So I don't go over there. I don't massage the dog. I don't rub the dog. I don't, you know, do anything other than reinforce the place command. Go to place and relax. So I want people to understand that by teaching your dog the place command, also, there's a little character in this corner. Click on that little character on the corner. Share this on Facebook. Share this on Twitter. Share this on Periscope. What you can also do is when you're on Periscope, what I'd like you to do is to start following me and then also turn your alerts on. That way, you'll be able to be alerted when I do new Periscopes. I've started doing a lot of these one-subject Periscopes. People seem to really, really like the one-topic Periscopes, so I'm going to start doing them. It's not a Q&A about anything other than place. So I did that last night. On Mondays and Wednesdays, I do that last night, but I do about 20 hours of free Periscope. Use food in a slip week for 12 to go pup for place? Absolutely. Absolutely. Yep. Absolutely. So, it's really, let's see, I'm in a better state of mind if I'm active, but I can't. It's like a trip just because I've been, yeah, exactly. Linda, can you close that door, please? All right. Right. So, you know, exactly. That's the thing, Jamie. You'd make a great example. You can't be a jerk just because you're stuck inside all day. Yeah, Angela just got hurt. I'm trying to get the door closed. So it's today's our last day in Florida. We head out tomorrow morning. We head out for Providence, Rhode Island. We go back there. I'll be back in Providence on and off for about 2 months. Our three-month tour to southern states is over, and we've got a bunch of great stuff. I've got an RV seminar. I've got an RV seminar that's coming up. I'm going to go pick up Kira. When people knock on the door, okay. I know he can't. I know. He's having a, he needs to take, he's been up early, very early in the morning. So they can't act out now, right? I used food to reinforce my dog in place, and then he was more anxious when I tried using an e-collar. So, you know, we don't use food to reinforce place at all. We just, when you teach place, you teach it from an educational standpoint, and then what you do is what you would do is you would correct it for non-compliance. So you don't have to keep rewarding the dog for staying there because the food actually will escalate the dog's excitement level. So I want dogs to be just doing nothing. I want the dogs to be doing nothing in place. I don't want them to be, they don't, they yes, they can chew a bone. Yes, they can have a toy. We don't though. At the beginning, Victor, of the learning stage, yes, you take, you would say no and bring the dog back. Once the dog has understood it, the no would be a correction. At the beginning, no is just informational. It's just informational. It's just no and then bring back. After you've been working on it, say for a week or a week and a half, you would say no, walk over, correct the dog, and the dog goes back in a place. You want to have a leash on your dog when you're doing this. You want to have a leash on your dog when you're doing this. And remember, that if you, the higher the level of the distraction is, the higher level of the distraction is, what will happen is it's harder for the dog to do it. That's just the way it is. It's the way it is. I mean, imagine if you're trying to work on a paper, and you're trying to write an article or a blog post, and the television is on, it's harder to pay attention. It's called a distraction. So it's no different. It's no different for the dog. It's no different for the dog. If you're just tuning in, welcome. If this is your first time being here, welcome. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Yeah. Corrections are not bad. All a correction is information. So the way that a lot of dog training and sorry, I'm just fiddling with my camera here. The way that dog training and the media and blog posts and a lot of websites, they make it seem like a correction is a bad thing. Corrections are great things. And not all that is information. All it is information. So what I'd like folks to do is teach your dog the place command. Your dog will be calmer. Your dog will be more respectful. You will eliminate 90% of the behavioral problems that you're struggling with. When a dog is in place, imagine this. If a dog is in place on a dog mat being calm, what are they not doing? They're not jumping on counters. They're not stealing food. They're not rushing the door. They're not barking uncontrollably. They're not knocking down your kids. They're not biting people. They're not getting into dog fights. They're not sitting out the windows waiting for a squirrel to run by. So the place command is awesome. Now, does your dog always have to be in place? No, it doesn't. But your dog should learn place. So I would say 90% of the time that girl has been inside this house, she's been in place. So what else would she be doing? Yes, it's much different than stay. I don't teach stay. So place command means, you might have just tuned in, so I'll repeat it. Place command is go to a object. So go to a dog bed, go to a blanket, go to a towel, go to a bath mat, go to a carpet square, lie down, and don't get off. We don't teach stay. Stay is default. Nope, you can have as many different objects as you can. What type of correction? All depends on what the dog is motivated with. If you've got a training collar on and a leash, you would say no. Give the dog a quick pop. If you're doing remote collar training, you would do remote collar training with the remote. A correction is a correction is a correction. Okay? So at the beginning, you don't correct the dog other than with a verbal no. But once you know for a matter of fact that dog knows that they know what place is, but they're breaking it, but they know they're not supposed to break it, you have to motivate the dog to stay on there. So then, does the dog stay on there because it's afraid of being corrected? Whatever. Maybe at the beginning it is, but eventually it does fine. Corrections, punishment, and aversives are not bad things. It's really hard to correct on a slip lead. It's really hard to train a dog on a slip lead. So I would switch off to, but you can give a pop on a slip lead. The problem is you're causing more damage correcting on a slip lead than you ever would on a prong collar. So correcting a dog on a slip lead would harm a dog more than a prong collar would. Prong collars are designed not to harm dogs. 12 weeks old, which should all be food training. 12 weeks old, your puppy can learn place at 8 weeks old. Puppies can learn, we give me an 8-week-old puppy, I'll teach it place. It's all food-based training. You're not going to get duration out of it, but you don't need to get duration. Because an 8-week-old puppy, all you're doing with an 8-week-old puppy is running it through drills, and then it goes to the bathroom, and then you crate it back up. So, yep. I have got over 1,000 videos. Go to my YouTube channel. I have videos on place. I've got a lot of videos on place. Right? I don't say this to brag or boast, but I've got a lot of videos. 50,000 Facebook posts. I document just about everything I do. We're very transparent. We show when it doesn't work as well, and we show you how to troubleshoot it. We do that on purpose. Right? Yeah. Place is probably one of the simplest commands to teach. Okay? Yep. Yes. Place is easier to teach than walking a dog on a leash. Place is easier to teach, in my opinion, than down. Place is easier to teach than sit. Place is easier to teach than recall. Place is easier to teach than... Place is probably one of the easiest commands out there. It's simple, simple, simple. Yep. It's very simple to do. So, this is one subject. Your dog does not have to be tired to be calm. That's another thing that we want to make sure that we get across to people. If your dog is misbehaving, it's not because they haven't had enough exercise. We don't expect duration from the pup. An 8-week-old puppy? No, we don't. The only duration we expect from an 8-week-old puppy is to go into your crate. Absolutely not. Yep, 12-week-old dog, if you're just starting doing place, I wouldn't expect much duration from it, but then I would only expect it when I'm in front of the dog. I would do lots of drills. 12-week-old puppy, we do lots of drills. So we would do recall, sit, place, recall, sit, place, all food-based, all with food. Okay. So my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. You can go to my website, Solid Canine Training. I've got a training facility up in Providence, Rhode Island. I travel the world doing seminars, and you can click on this little character in the corner, share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter. You can also share this on Periscope. You can invite your fans, invite your friends. Give me hearts, heart, 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 hearts. Also on the replays, you can swipe and share with food and dragging leash on a prong. Yep. Well, with a 12-week-old puppy, you don't need to even have a leash on the dog half the time. When we work with young puppies, you don't even need a leash because they're just hungry. It's just all food. It's just all food. Yeah, but you can have a dragging leash with a prong and you can have food. Yep, you can have food. But not for a 12-week-old puppy. 12-week-old puppy is just food. Yep, that's easy to do. Puppies are hungry. They'll do anything. So they'll do anything. If you only use food for training, you'll get a young puppy to do just about anything you need them to do. Nope, not at all. If your puppy is tired, he'll probably not want to work. And he'll probably want to nip you more. Tired puppies nip. No. I don't want my dogs to be tired to work. I want my dogs to have lots of energy when they're working. So that's usually an excuse for someone, not you personally, but for a lot of trainers that have got a bad training program. Okay, your dog does not need to be tired at all. Dog does not need to be tired at all. To me, a 6-month-old dog is capable of doing a lot of stuff. So I wouldn't consider that a puppy. Medically, it's a puppy. Yes, medically, it's absolutely a puppy. But from a training standpoint, puppies are like under 14 weeks old. That's where like we would do different training. Yeah. And when you start training your dog, the minute you're already training it, the minute you come in contact with it. So, all right. So your dog does not have to be tired to pay attention. Your dog doesn't have to be tired to relax. My dogs are never tired when I make them relax. No, they're always in drive. That makes sense. Mastiff mix, 1 hour. 1 hour of training is a lot of dog, is a lot of training. It's a lot of training. All right. That's what I got for you right now. All right. I just wanted to do a one subject periscope. People have really been liking these one subject periscopes. So I've been doing that. So this was one of my one subject periscopes. Combination of, you don't have to have a tired dog. Don't have to have a tired dog to get to relax. And one of the greatest things to do is to teach your dog the place command, because that actually gets your dog to relax and to be calm. It's not an on-off periscope, but that's one of the ways that I get dogs to turn them off, is place or down. Yep. Go here. Good girl. So for instance, today, what did I do with girl? We walked a 1/4 mile to an open field. We played chuck it for 5 minutes. We'll go swimming for 10 minutes. And that will be your exercise today. Think about that. Could she do more? Yeah, she can do a ton more. But it's not like I'm like, and she's a high drive dog. You've seen her work. Yes. Yes, Victor. It's harder, but that's the goal. That's the goal. That's the goal, Victor. Is that if you have multiple dogs, you can have dogs. Because we do that at our training center. What are you eating?
Chips.
Why don't you put some shredded cheese on that? We'll nuke them. We'll heat them up. Because I think there's some shredded cheese there. We leave today for Rhode Island. Everyone's a little bit sad.
We're leaving tomorrow.
We leave tomorrow. We'll do a periscope. We'll do an RV periscope. Spray the chips out on one of the plates right there. Ooh, we have sausage left. Let's cut up the sausage. Cut up the sausage. Put it on top of the chips. Put the cheese on top of that. Nuke it for 44 seconds.
Who's going to cut that sausage?
I will. Wait 5 minutes, okay? Wait 5 minutes. Whenever you use the microwave, you always do 22, 44, 55. Why? You don't have to lift your finger off the button. You just go boom, 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 boom. Right? Why do 60? Because then you got to go 60 when you can do 55 and just hit the 5 twice. You don't have to move your finger off the button. Does anybody else out there do that, or is that just me? You do it too, Mama. I know. Anybody else? Anybody else? Use this plate, sweetheart. It's already been used. Yep.
Right?
Angela, you want to do a Periscope? You want to do your own Periscope? You want to show people your new toy?
No. No, Papa.
He doesn't want to, but let me see if we can do it. Okay.
This one.
What did you get? Did you get a new one today?
Yeah.
Which one did you get today? Stand right there so people can see you.
Rubber dog.
Let me see.
Rubber dog right here.
Girl plots.
Right here. See?
No. I'm looking at you. No, so I'm looking at you. So you stay on this side of the screen. So yeah, everybody can see you.
Yeah.
So let me see. What did you get?
Rubber dog.
And what does it do?
His bad works.
Yep. Yeah.
Moves.
What are those things called?
Oh.
Paw Patrols?
Yeah.
Angelo loves Paw Patrols.
Yeah, this Paw Patrol is. What's the podcast? Yeah.
I don't know. Do you have any more Paw Patrols over there?
Yeah. Over there, right there.
Are they in your bag? Mm-hmm. Are they lined up?
Yeah. Oh, I will be right back.
Well, we'll come over there. We'll come over there. Yeah, we will. Oh, look at all these Paw Patrols.
So this is Robert Duck Bash, and then you can take the side, and it has the back, and it has the front ways.
Okay. And what else you got there? What are your other Paw Patrols' names?
Oh, every Swivel.
Well, hold them up so everybody can see them. Yeah, but hold them up in front of the iPad.
Is there stick?
Yep, like that. Okay.
So this one is blue.
Yep.
Robot dog. Marshall.
Marshall.
And Marshall. Another Marshall.
Two Marshalls.
Yep. And two Rubbles.
Two Rubbles. Rubbles are the ones with the backhoe, right?
Marshall.
They can pick up their own poop. For treadmill walking, you can start out at 5 minutes and then work your way up to half an hour if you want to. The dog will let you know. You'll let yourself know.
Yeah.
Right? You've seen the puppies on the treadmill, right?
Wobble, wobble.
Angela, who runs on the treadmill at home? Fabienne, the chihuahua, right?
Well, she doesn't like it.
How about Kaiser likes it, though, right?
He does, but Fabi doesn't.
No, Fabi doesn't.
No. She gets off sometimes.
Yeah. And sometimes they poop on it, right? Yeah. All right, you want to say goodbye, Periscope?
Not yet.
All right, well then.
I gotta keep this Everest Wubble Wubble and Rocky and Zuba and Bash right there. Well, this Bash doesn't talk, but one Wubble Ducky Mouse is a little.
Yeah, these are Angela's favorite things. They're called Paw Patrols.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wubble Dog, Everest Wubble.
He loves
it. Wait, I'm missing Paw Patrols. I'm missing...
Where are they?
Chase and Sky. I'm missing.
Yes, I have, Hot Mom. I talk about everything. I'll do another Ask Jeff Anything. Anyway, this is one of my other kids. Romy. This is Linda.
Nice. Mama.
This is Girl.
And then, where's Clover?
Where's Clover?
Where's she?
I'll do it again, One Hot Mom. I think it's online, too. All right. All right, everybody. I'm heading off, I should say. All right. Yeah, Linda's online. She's always online making deals. She's always online. What's that, honey?
Are you
going to
be off
Periscope? Yeah, I'm going to go off Periscope now, okay? All right. All right, madly in love with all of you. Take care. Remember, let's get me over to Japan. Come on now. Let's get me over to Japan.